So we shall not be concerned with pious activities or impious activities. We shall be concerned with transcendental activities that will save me from this bondage of birth, death, old age and disease. That should be our aim of life. We should not be hankering after good or bad things, because everything here, in higher consciousness, everything material. Now, take for example, suppose you are diseased, suffering from some disease, you are lying on the bed, and you are eating in that stage, you are passing your nature's call in that way, and taking bitter medicines, and always you have to keep by the nurses clean, otherwise there is some obnoxious smell. In such a condition you are lying, and some friends come to you and ask you, "My dear such and such, how are you today feeling?" "Yes, I am today feeling well." "What is this well?" He is lying on the bed, he is passing his nature's course in that way, he is eating bitter medicine, and he cannot move, all these inconveniences, and he says that, "I am well." Similarly, in our material consciousness of life, if we think I am happy, that is foolishness. That is foolishness. There is no happiness in material life. It is impossible to get happiness. Then we do not know meaning of happiness. That way this very word is used, manish, you know. We want to happy to become by some extraneous, artificial means. And how long it will stand? It will not stand. It will again come back. Suppose by intoxication you feel happy. Oh, that is not your actual happiness. Suppose by chloroform, I am unconscious, I don't feel the pains of operation. Oh, that does not mean that I am out of these pains and pleasures. This is artificial. So real pleasure, real life is here. As recommended in Bhagavad Gita by Sri Krishna. Just see. Karmajang buddhijuktahi phalana takta manishina. Manishina means the thoughtful. They give up the reaction of work, being situated in the platform of consciousness, and the result will be the janmabandham vinirmukta. This bondage of birth and death and disease and old age, he becomes free from that. Then the next life, padam gacchanti anamayam. Anamayam. Anamayam means where there is no death, the old age, no birth, no disease. That is possible. That is called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha. The Sanskrit word is Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means vigata kuntha. Kuntha means anxiety. Anxiety. Here, due to our material contamination, we are always full of kuntha, anxiety. Even a bird, when he is eating, he is seeing like this, this way, this way, this way. Somebody is coming, kill me. Full of anxiety. We are also anxious. The politician is anxious. So long we are in contamination of these material body, we must be anxious. We must be anxious. There is a nice instruction by Prahlad Maharaj, a great devotee, a boy devotee. And he was from his boyhood, childhood, from his mother's womb, he became a devotee by the grace of Narada Muni. That is history. Now, he was 5 years old boy, and his father was too much materialistic. And he wanted that his son should be great politician, economist and so on, just like the materialists want. But the boy is a devotee. So father did not like the idea. So one day he called his boy, "My dear boy, come on." He came, small boy, "Sit down on my lap." "All right, my dear boy, will you kindly tell me what you have learned, the best thing in your school?" "Yes, my dear father, I shall tell you." So he says like this, "Tatsadumanne suravarja dihinam Sada samad bhigna dhyam asad grihat hitya atma ghatam grihyanda kupam banangato jad harima srayita. My dear father, he is addressing his father, oh, the best amongst the materialists. Well, he is not afraid. His father was very powerful. And there is a story we shall narrate one day. Now, today is shortly I am giving some instance. So, he says, my dear father, you are the greatest of the materialists. But, to my opinion, that is the best thing. If people should give up this materialistic life and devote himself for searching out God, then he will be free from the anxieties which is due to him, due to his material connection. That's how silly nice. The hitya, tasad manne suravarja dekhna sada samudvigna dhiyam. Persons who are always full of anxieties. Why? That due to their material connection. Asat. Asat means matter. Matter will not stay. However, you may chemically try to preserve it, it will not stay. Therefore, it matters. Another name is Asat. And spirits, another name is Sat. Sat means which exists. Asat means which does not exist. Antamatti niti ha. Nitta sukta sarivina. We have already discussed that this body is antavat. It has got end. But the consciousness or the spirit soul, it is not, it is endless. So the endless, I mean to say ever existent soul being contaminated by this body is full of anxiety. So Prahlad Maharaj thinks that in order to realize his self for self-realization, if he gives up all material engagement and takes to the path of self-realization, that is the best way of his life. And the father became angry, what nonsense he is taking. The 5 years old boy is talking of self-realization, I wanted to make him a great politician, economist, now he is talking of this nonsense and hityatma ghatam grihanda kupam. He is describing that this family life is just like a dark well, whatever you want, that doesn't matter. But act it on the platform of consciousness. And that platform, acting on the consciousness, is Lord Chaitanya has made very easy. Just like there are some note makers of school books and easy study. So Lord Chaitanya has recommended that you may be engaged in whatever occupation that may be, good or bad, we don't mind for that. But you must hear the Krishna Katha. You must continue to hear this Bhagavad Gita. That is, for this we are trying to organize this institution. That you come, whatever you do, that doesn't matter. Everything will be adjusted by and by. Because, as I have described in the beginning, the Simmatang Sarata Krishna Vidyantas Avadhrad, everything will be adjusted as our mind becomes clear, 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 simply by hearing. Simply by hearing. Thank you very much.